35-year-old Ricardo Villalba. He's fought in the United States before, but it's the first time he's fighting in California. Y saludos a toda la gente que nos está mirando en Buenos Aires por la página de YouTube. Ricardo Villalba is a Boca Juniors fan. Big soccer team out there.
Yeah.
So he's got the Argentina flag.
He's in his 30th professional fight, so tough veteran.
Bebo is his nickname, B-E-B-O. You got Daniel Bustos. That's his trainer. And the Argentinian accent is strong.
And next to make his way to the ring, here's the undefeated middleweight from Los Angeles. Please welcome Eric Preece.
The rock music's been coming strong tonight. 24 years old, Eric Preece, making his Golden Boy debut. Worked out at Churchill Boxing Club on the west side of LA. I called a couple of his fights. He's fun to watch. 6 foot, originally from Kansas City, Kansas. Half Korean. He fought on the Regis and Chon Cepeda undercard on Thanksgiving weekend in Carson, and he had a first round KO. And now signed to Golden Boy.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, 8 rounds scheduled. This in the middleweight division. The 3 judges scoring at ringside are Carla Caiz, Patricia Morse Jarman, and Thomas Taylor. And when the action begins inside the ring, your referee in charge, Jerry Cantu. Introducing to you first, finding out of the blue corner, wearing black with silver, he weighed officially 160 pounds even. In 29 professional fights, his record stands at 20 victories, 8 defeats, 1 draw with 8 wins coming by way of knockout from Buenos Aires, Argentina. Here is Ricardo El Bebo Villalba. And across the ring, his opponent fighting out of the red corner, wearing red trunks trimmed in silver and white. He weighed in 159 3/4 pounds, and in 9 professional bouts, holds a perfect record of 9 victories, no defeats, 7 wins coming by way of knockout. Here's the undefeated middleweight from Los Angeles, California, Eric Preece.
Mouthpiece. Gentlemen, you have received your instructions in the dressing room. You will obey my commands at all times. Estás recibiendo sus instrucciones en el camarino. Todo lo toques. Bueno.
Jerry Cantu, the third man in the ring. It's our final bout here on YouTube. Middleweight division at the top of the hour. We get going on DAZN. Scrappy Ramirez will open that up at 6 o'clock. But right now it's Eric Preece making his Golden Boy debut. Last year, Preece fought 3 times. He had 3 rounds. 3 first-round knockouts for Eric Preece in 2022. He packs power. I've worked 2 of his fights they did last year. And he comes in. He has a good style, Jones. It was against good opposition he had also. Guys with a winning record, 2 of them. 2 fighters were undefeated, and he knocked him out. So he comes in quick.
Not only knocked him out, you said first-round knockout, yep. So it's definitely a confidence booster for him.
But then again, the question is, well, he only had 3 rounds in the whole year, so do you want to – how much work did you get, you know? Where his opponent, Villalba, fought in February, and he got knocked out in the second. But before that, he went 6 rounds, 10 rounds. So the more active fighter has been Villalba, rounds-wise. But let's see what Preece has here. Oscar De Loya, if you follow Oscar's social media account, was really posting about Preece a lot, really excited about him, especially in the press release that Jay Mercia sent out. The quotes from Oscar, just talking to him yesterday, or Thursday at the press conference, I like this guy. Something I see in him. And he's loading up on the right hand.
Those three first-round knockouts help.
Yeah. And the middleweight division is interesting. Middleweight fight that was announced recently for is going to be Demetrius Battler. Big Meech is going to be taking on Shane Mosley Jr. in the middleweight division. And we're right next to the corner of the Alba, so you'll be hearing the Spanish from the Argentine. Priest trained by Pedro Nemi Jr. It was Marky Nieves, his cut man in the corner. You see the tattoo, the Korean flag and the U.S. flag on the left shoulder of Priest.
They're both stiffing each other. I'm sure they felt the power.
Priest sitting down on his punches here with 45 seconds to go in the first round.
Priest trying to dig the body a little bit.
Villalba, not much power behind him. Only 8 stoppages. Well, a couple of people I talked to, they said he's game, he's tough. He'll battle with you. But don't expect a big knockout from Villalba. He's going to have to put combinations together. Where Priest has that one-hitter quitter.
Yeah, definitely 7 KOs in 9 fights. He's definitely got that pop.
Yeah, he got that eraser. 10 seconds to go in the opening round. Filling out round. Scheduled for 8 here in Indio, California. Crowd filling in here at Fancy Springs Resort Casino. The main event tonight, Alexis Rocha, Anthony Young on the zone. Timekeeper Keenan blows the whistle as the fight is back out for the second round. Nine and 0, 7 KOs. He's 6 foot, is Eric Priest. It's interesting, the fight before this, Johnny Cañas, 6'1", 135. Priest, 6 foot, 160. Boxers come in different sizes.
Different sizes, different shapes.
And what are you, 5'10"?
I'm 5'10", 135.
And hey, we're going to see different sizes later on, too. The minimum weight title is on the line, 105 pounds. Jerusalem and Collazo will be going at it.
Very hard to find fighters that size.
Well, they don't even have that size in the Olympics. That's why Collazo turned pro.
Yeah. Don't blame him.
All right, so Priest. Yeah, the red and silver. Feeling out. He knows that this is a step up in competition because the style that Villalba brings here. And you, as you move up, Jose, you're Priest 9-0. He's taking on a guy in his 30th fight in Villalba. So what's the attitude when you're, okay, I know this guy has way more experience than that.
You just want to improve. He knows this guy is this 30th fight. Priest, he just wants to get better and better. And obviously upping the competition is only going to get you better.
But is there ever a case where maybe you respect them a little too much?
There could be a case like that.
Early in the rounds? Or
early in the fight. But after you get a feel for it, you just get comfortable and you just start letting loose.
Like he's starting to do now. He split the guard. A good solid 1-2. Double up the jab is Priest. Villalba ready to be more defensive.
Good right hand by Priest. Another one.
Solid by Priest.
He's sitting down with those punches a lot more in this round. Priest is.
Villalba with his mouth open. He got the call for this fight a week ago. In California adjusted. Making noise as he throws the punches, this Priest. There you go, beautiful. Like I said, I called two of his fights last year. Couldn't really figure out much for Priest because his opponent came in willing to trade with him and he cracked him. It's more of the boxing from what I've heard of Priest.
You can't tell much about a fighter when they get him out of the first round.
You know, especially when you knock
you're supposed
out.
To be filling them out and stuff like that. But some people just like to come in and take them out.
Some guys come in to fight like they're double parked. How about the opponents?
Yeah, definitely. You come in, you just want to get out of there. Make a quick night.
Second round winding down is scheduled for 8. Our last fight here on the YouTube page at the top of the hour, DAZN takes over. So make sure you download the DAZN app. You'll be busy. Golden Boys will be busy. Fights in June, fights in July. Highlights from the second round. Joe, what do you see here?
See a good body shot land by Priest. I see him getting comfortable. There you see the jab at the end of the combination.
All right, so we've had a couple filling out rounds. It's only scheduled for 8. Is this where Priest kind of starts stepping on the gas?
Definitely. It's only scheduled for 8 rounds. This is his third round. This is as much as he's gone all of last year. So I'm sure he's going to... He's getting anxious. He wants to get a knockout or at least a knockdown.
He moves back the elbow. At what point do you realize, okay, this guy doesn't have much power. I can do what I want now.
Around this point of the fight, really? You're in the third round. You start seeing, you already felt their power. You already felt their speed, their timing, and this is where you start going to work.
Yeah, because Villalba more on the defensive, keeping that guard really high. Priest.
He probably felt Priest's power from the previous rounds, and now he's just very cautious. It's going to be harder to knock him out now.
Yeah, Priest has been first the entire fight. Trying to go upstairs, but Villalba keeping that guard super high, super tight. He throws it, that left hand comes back immediately. Nice jab from Priest.
Priest is looking very, very comfortable right now in the fight. Snapping that jab, moving his head, catching the shots.
Yeah, starting to split the guard at times.
Nice check hook right there.
All right, what's a check hook?
Check hook is a quick little check hook. You just make sure you want to check them. That's why they call it a check hook.
It's not the big one that's going to knock people out.
Not the big one. It's just a quick little, you know.
Just
hey,
let them know you're here.
Hey, I'm here.
Like, keep the hand up because something might else follow.
Something else is going to follow it, or who knows? Maybe that one might just put you down.
Yeah. Upstairs is where Peace is trying to go. He slips.
No slip in the ring.
Feet tangled up. And you see some
good
redness.
Sportsmanship.
Yep. Some redness on the nose of Villalba, the Argentine in black. Yeah, it's going to be Priest first at all times.
Yeah, he's been first. I'm seeing Villalba take the headshots really well. I'd want to see Priest go down a little bit more to the body.
He hasn't had any body shots at all.
Taking the headshots, we'll see how he takes the body shots.
Ten seconds to go in the third. Schedule for 8. Our final bout here on the Golden Boy YouTube page. Make sure you follow us. Golden Boy social media accounts for behind-the-scenes pictures of Leo Sanchez and Johnny Canyas, who already got the victories here tonight. Also, the arrivals of Scrappy Ramirez, they're already posted. June 8th. Golden Boy will be back here. Golden Boy Fight Night on Thursday, then June 10th, Ontario. And stay tuned for news of when Jose Gonzalez gets back into the ring. I'm not going to say I saw you trying to make a fight, but I saw you trying to make a fight. We won't say any names, but Joe's over here telling everybody I'm ready. Our main event tonight, Alexis Rocha, Anthony Young, the co-feature, Oscar Duarte, who used to train here in India with Joel Diaz, and D'Angelo Keys. Melvin Jerusalem, Oscar Callazo for the WBO 105-pound belt. And the opener, Scrappy Ramirez, Fernando Diaz. Diaz from Riverside, Scrappy from L.A. That's going to be a good scrap. Oh, man, I can't believe I just fell for that. Scrappy got me. This will be a good fight. That's at the top of the hour. Right now, it's Eric Priest controlling this fight. He's in the red and silver. All right, this is where, as we said it with Leo Sanchez, you don't want to play with your food, right? You want to get him out as soon as possible.
Definitely don't want to play with your food at all. Priest is obviously the more skilled fighter. He's seen that Bebel has been taking his face shots really well. See if he can take the body shots. I would invest in the body for the later rounds. See if he can get him out of there.
Yeah, we haven't seen any body shots at all from Eric Priest.
He's working off the jab really well. He's got to right there come with the body shot or something. Good right hand.
Bebel knows how to slip those.
He's rolling with them nice.
He's getting hit but not flush.
That's a big difference.
Some swelling now around the nose and the left eye of the Argentine.
Good hook by Priest.
Now that was a real hook, not a check hook.
Definitely, that was a real hook. You heard the thud.
Yeah, you heard the ooh for the crowd also. In the corner of the Abba right next to us, to keep the hand up. Might have been a little low. I see what you're talking about, Joe. That body right now is open.
Wide open. He's got to just start digging in. Invest in the body shots.
And Villalba now breathing with the mouth wide open. Less than a minute to go in the fourth round.
When you start seeing that, you really want to start digging the body because you know it's an eight-round fight. We're barely in four. He's already breathing from his mouth. Sometimes fighters don't collapse or go down because of they're actually hurt. They go down because they're tired and they need a breather.
Villalba's shown that he can take a punch upstairs. There's that
body shot.
You can hear the thud. More of that. That's what you want, Jules?
Definitely more of that. He had a reaction, so that means it hurt him.
He's good at slipping it. Is the Argentine in black.
Very good. He's rolling with them nice. They're not landing flush. They're landing, but not flush.
As we head to the fifth round. Jamming inside the Event Center Fantasy Springs. Golden Boy on Memorial Weekend. Thank you for joining us this Saturday night. Bethel Duran alongside with Golden Boy's Jose Gonzalez. When's your brother turning pro?
I'm not sure. You know, he's staying in the gym. We'll see when the opportunity comes, and when it comes, he'll be ready for it.
John Heidel, right?
Yeah, definitely.
That's my guy.
We all grew in reverse. Joette being the oldest, he's the smallest, and then me, the middle. Or second oldest, bigger than Joy, and then you got Heidel, and he's bigger than all of us.
Yeah, I like him. Good family that your father and mother have, and especially the gym, everybody there. Azusa Boxing is where you started?
That's where we started. We are at Cape Fitness in Laverne now.
You guys have your own, the Gonzalez. And an excellent amateur program that you guys have.
Yeah, definitely. My dad has a group of kids that he trains. And, you know, they're on the way as well.
You guys, you have them running with you, have them training with you.
Running with us, training with us, sparring with us, you know, everything. It's a family.
And, of course, shout out to your brother, Jason.
Yeah, the biggest critic of the family.
You want to talk about a critic or a broadcaster, I'm scared of Jason. He'll let me know.
He'll let you know.
But shout out to Jason. You're here the fifth round of action. Part of the reason I'm bringing up the amateur program that your family has, do that, is because in this venue is where they have the Desert Showdown, a big amateur program, and Eric Priest from Kansas City, Kansas, that's also one of the spots where they have a big tournament out there, right?
The ringside.
The ringside.
Yeah.
Yeah,
so it's one of the big tournaments, yes.
Yeah, so the amateur programs, as you go and you develop, and when you translate to the pros, what's the biggest difference, Jels?
The speed of it. The speed of it. In the pros, you're much more calm, relaxed, and you got a longer fight ahead of you. And the amateur is just about go get your points, and that's probably the biggest difference.
And right now with Eric Priest is noticing as you progress and you have a fighter with 30 fights underneath his belt, which you did
and knows how to survive.
Yep, which you did against a guy who only had 6-7 fights. Is it going to work as effectively?
Yeah, no, definitely not, because he knows how to, the other fighter, 35 veteran, knows how to survive. He's going to let you come in, throw your punches, waste your energy, and then he's going to just feel it out, roll with it, and at the end of the day, survive.
As we mentioned, Priest only had 3 rounds last year. So getting quality rounds against a solid opponent.
As good as development as a professional.
Who gives you that professional resistance.
Yeah.
And now Priest is showing some different wrinkles, going upstairs and downstairs.
Showing that he has good boxing skills too, rather than just power.
Good jab. We got some blood.
A cut on the bridge of the nose.
Right on that last punch at the end of the round. The blood on the bridge of the nose for the Argentine Ricardo Villalba. Going to the 6th round. Now that corner of Villalba is working quick on the nose. Sixth round of action, Eric Priest and Ricardo Villalba, our last fight here on the YouTube portion at the top of the hour. DAZN takes over. I'll be on the call alongside Chris Mannix and Sergio Mora, and it opens up with Scrappy Ramirez. And now some urgency from Villalba. That nose is busted on the bridge, the right eye is swelling, and they told him in the corner to pick it up. And he has more energy here.
Hey, definitely came out swinging. He knows he's behind on the cards, and that cut on the nose doesn't do him any justice.
Yep, and it's bleeding immediately. They worked on it, but it's bleeding, so it's up to Priest to jump on this. All right, I'm gonna ask a dumb question. When a guy's cut like that, what do you do?
Jump on him or attack it. Right, attack the part that's injured.
Another dumb question. Do you see it?
Definitely you see it. Definitely you see it.
No, because, I mean, you know, sometimes there's blood, but you don't know where it's coming from, right? Or is that
most
just a
of the
dumb
time,
question?
You know where it's coming from. And it's so weird, like the blood from a cut versus the blood from the bloody nose, it smells different in there.
It smells
different.
Really?
Yeah, it smells different. You can smell it.
There's a lot of
stuff
going on.
That's why I say
you
smell the blood, go for the kill.
So, I never heard that before, but
crazy.
I'm listening. I'm fascinated now. So you can smell.
You smell the
different
blood.
Sense of
it
blood.
Smells like much more like iron. Like you smell that
which
metal.
Which one?
When you get a gash from a headbutt, a punch from the eyebrow, from the nose, from wherever, versus a nosebleed.
Okay, so the nosebleed smells like what?
You don't really smell that.
It's just blood.
It's just blood.
But some forehead.
When you
clash.
Smell that, it smells like iron, and you just smell that heavy metal, and you just.
Yeah.
Yeah,
like,
definitely.
Like you're driving by a construction site.
Yeah, I remember the first time it was one of my amateur fights. I smelled the blood. I was like, whoa, this is different.
So that's what they're talking about.
Yeah.
Less than a minute to go in the sixth round. Finally, some body work from Priest. One punch at a time, though.
I like to see him double up on that.
The corner of Villalba is telling you the experience on your side. He definitely has the experience. Combinations from Priest. Pounds, the middleweight division.
Good short hook by Priest right there.
It's an interesting division, too. Priest in his ninth pro fight. 24-year-old for Kansas City, Kansas. There it is, working on the bridge of the nose of Ricardo Villalba. 30 pro fights down. He walks in. When I saw him at the weigh-ins yesterday, I'm like, yep, he's a fighter.
He's got that face of a fighter.
Oh, yeah. I didn't know what he looked like or anything like that, but he walked in the way, I'm like, who are you fighting? He said, Priest.
So people just got that face.
Yep. Argentina, you think about a man who trained here, Lucas Matisse.
Think about Matisse, the Maidanas.
Brian Castano, who's a recent champion.
A lot of good fighters coming out of there. Tough fighters.
Yep. A lot of fighters from Argentina, a lot of pride. And you'll see an Argentina fighter, I think almost every fight I work with, like whether it's a club show or a bigger show, there's usually an Argentina fighter on the B side who comes in tough as nails, makes it hard for you, and the undefeated fighter, the young prospect, walks away like, what the heck did you, I just, what was this?
Like, yeah, it's different. They take their fighting seriously and like with a lot of pride.
Absolutely.
They're not just going to come in here and take a dive.
At all. I kid you not, I worked a fight recently. The dude was 44 years old. He is a chicken farmer and lost split decision.
Wow.
Against a kid who was 9-0, and he told me, I work on a farm, I'm farm strong, I do this, I don't need to lift weight. I'm like, why are you fighting? He's like, oh, because I love beating young kids. And his record, he was like 15-24, but he's always against a young prospect who's like 7-0, 8-0, and he takes their own.
You know, those farm workers are strong too. You know, they're saying in Mexico, the people that milk the cows and work with the cattle, they can crack.
On the rancho.
I believe it, you know?
Well, that's actually Oscar Duarte, who we're going to see at the co-feature tonight. His family has a farm, and he works on the farm baling hay. So
and you look at him, and he's a good, solid power puncher.
Doesn't lift weights.
Hey, he lifts hay.
Halfway through the seventh round, scheduled for eight. Eric Priest controlling this fight against the very tough and game Ricardo Villalba. Middleweights. More blood from the nose of Villalba. Finally, Priest attacking the body. A minute to go in the round. If he went to the body, would it be done?
Definitely be a different story right now. If you went to the body early in the fight, you would see Villalba breathing much more heavier. And especially with that blood on the nose, it'd be harder for him to breathe right now.
He would have took a toll?
Definitely would have taken a toll. But it's good. It's like an investment. Oh, his mouthpiece came out. See if Priest can capitalize on it.
Mouthpiece went out. Those body shots.
He's breathing from his mouth. That's why the mouthpiece came out.
Yeah, there's more blood. And that, right now when he spit out, it was all blood he spit.
Maybe it was a tactic to catch his breath.
Again, the veterans do that. They know how to find and get themselves an extra couple seconds.
They do.
Great
jab by Priest.
I like the old one of, all of a sudden, the bucket of ice slips at the end of the round. I mean, at the end of the minute.
Oh, we got to clean it up.
No, we got to clean. It was just enough. Final seconds of the seventh round. Villalba, respect to him, asking Priest to come bring it. And after every round, Villalba shakes hands with Priest. You like it, guys, do that?
Not really. I'm here to fight. I'm here to fight. I don't like it. I don't like touching gloves before or after the fight. You know, when that final bell rings, then okay, we can give each other our respect. But during the fight, you know, there's no friends in that ring.
I know you touch when the fight starts because
when
you have
when it starts and when it ends.
And then
besides that, I will not touch gloves.
You know what? Right. I'm right there with you.
Like, it's a fight, you know?
He's
coming to hurt me. I'm coming to hurt him.
And it's like, yeah, okay, cool. That was a good round. Yeah, man. I'm supposed to knock you out.
Good job, bro. No. We're not done yet. We're fighting.
But a lot of guys do that as like a mental side, too.
Yeah. To let them know, like, oh, you didn't do anything to me.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like it's like a mind game, you know? You do it in sparring, but in the fight.
Okay, sparring is a different story.
Sparring is a different story. We're there to help each other grow. Right here, we're here to hurt each other.
It's like, hey, I'm happy to have gotten with you. You're like, man, I should have knocked you out in the fourth.
Yeah.
What are you doing here? All right, ask Villalba's corner, what'd you tell him? He's like, oh, he's fine. He's just being too cautious because of the cut. He thinks it's worse than it really is. It's not. Yeah, so he's being cautious because of the cut. But it wasn't exactly any advice to, like, go out there and do something. It's more like they want to survive.
It's the last round. He should
they just want to survive.
To come out. He probably knows this fight's not going to be won.
Yeah.
He just wants to survive, live to fight another day.
You're a Priest. I mean, get into fifth gear right now, no?
Right here, you got to try to put them punches together and try to get him out of there. You see you hurt him. You see that cut on the nose is bothering him. See what you can do with it.
Put the combinations and just don't let him breathe, huh?
He steps back, follow up pressure. This is where you got to put it in extra gear.
Close the show.
Yeah, definitely.
There's that right hand deflected by Villalba.
Villalba is definitely being very cautious.
Now I understand what you're saying, Joseph. If he had gone to the body earlier, Villalba wouldn't have any kind of strength to be standing.
It would have been a different fight. He probably would have taken a knee from exhaustion. Not because he's hurt, but because he's tired.
Yeah, he's been breathing with his mouth open since the fourth round. Less than a minute to go in the fight. Top of the hour, DAZN takes over. Villalba came to survive and give him rounds. He did that.
Credit to him.
Yeah, credit to him. Priest gets good work. Fought three rounds last year. Actually, less than three rounds because we're all first round knockouts.
And now he comes in and he does eight.
Well, you see something there. He's got the look. He's got the ability. He's got the talent. Builds on this. Eight rounder. There's something there with Eric Priest.
Hey, this is eighth round. He's looking still pretty fresh.
Yeah.
So it's definitely something to build.
And that'll do it. They go the distance. Eric Priest and Argentina's Ricardo Villalba. Villalba thanking the crowd. In the corner of Priest. So we'll go to the judges' scorecards. Remember, the top of the hour is DAZN. Scrappy Ramirez, Fernando Diaz, and then the main event. is going to be Alexis Rocha, Anthony Young. Make sure you download the DAZN app. So there'll be a... I think we figure out these cards. It's going to be... Priest should get the victory here.
Yeah, definitely.
His 10th pro fight for Eric Priest. A step up in competition was good for him.
Yeah, big step up. You know, he's going up against a 35 veteran.
Good quality work.
A 35 veteran with a winning record.
Yep. Joe Martinez has our winner.
Well, five fans, after eight rounds, we go to the scorecards, and here are the totals. Carla Caiz and Thomas Taylor both see it 80-72. Patricia Morse-Jarman has it 79-73. All for your winner by unanimous decision, and still undefeated, Eric Priest.
Eric Priest gets the victory. He's now 10-0, goes the distance. Gets quality work in his Golden Boy debut. Ricardo Villalba falls to 29-1. Respect between the two fighters there. So he gets the victory. All right, here, trying to figure out who's going to step on me.